next door neighbor. Threw out all his hair, just like Karl Marx.
Hello. My name's John. Welcome to my podcast. This would be episode number 28 of The Snout. We were a band. We are listening to a tape made on April 9th, 1998. Side A starts with Gypsy Next Door Neighbor. That's what we're listening to, which goes into Aluminized Mylar. Then we have Then She Kissed Me, those amazing two chords, which becomes Catching Satan in a Jar. And then we have Don't Smoke, which turns into Mumbledy Scum. And then we'll get to side two when we get there. So if you heard the lyrics that Mike used when he started, it was, "My gypsy next door neighbor grew out all his hair just like Karl Marx." No idea where that came from. Mike has such a great mind. Let's turn this up a little bit and listen and see what we're doing. What I want to determine is who's playing guitar on this. I know Mike is. Matt's playing bass. We got the drum machine playing drums. I'm doing my keyboard thing. And I think Mike is the wah-wah guitar you hear. But in the right channel, there's a lower toned guitar, I think. I'm guessing that's John. It doesn't sound like Matt, but there were also times when we had three guitars, when John and Matt were both there. I'm going to turn this up a little bit. Fucking cool, I have to say. Yeah, that's a pretty cool thing. Think about where we've come from, you know? A year and a half of getting together on a semi-weekly basis. We've come a long way. This is pretty cool. I don't know whether you like it, but as far as where we are in our music, this has come a long way. So I'm going to fast forward a little bit, and we'll see what's up next here. I don't know if we'll be listening to any of Aluminized Mylar, because it's basically the same thing, but I want to get to Then She Kissed Me, because that's fun.
My gypsy next door neighbor grew his hair out just like Karl Marx.
Oh, still that. I just love that, though. Where does that come from? my gypsy next door neighbor grew out all his hair just like Karl Marx. I've never thought about Karl Marx's hair. Yeah, this is now in. Staring at the sun through aluminized mylar. The music doesn't change much when he goes into that. So, you know, in epic jam band fashion, that is one song going into another, I guess. Oh, we're still at it. Sorry, got distracted for a second by something falling. Let's see if we can get past this. You can hear us going.
Snap music.
Mike yelling, snap music. Let's see what happens here. This is the transition between songs. Figure out what we're going to do. We have no idea. That's what's so cool about this. Everything just comes to be kind of its own volition. And then it's not a group of musicians. It is one beast named the Snout. Just doing its thing. Everything comes naturally, all made up on the spot, all evolving as you listen. Check what this turns into.
I so got to try, she kissed me. I love the fact she kissed me. Mom and wife would hate it if they knew that she kissed me.
Kissed.
Wait. and Ed Wild was that tongue. I'm so surprised.
That's, and this one, I don't know if you were listening musically there. I don't know what you'd call this. Listen to John playing guitar on the left. Using that wah-wah. So that is "And She Kissed Me," or then She Kissed Me. Let's move forward, see if we can't get to the amazing two chords is really just that, two chords, but it turns into "Catching Satan in a Jar," which is really cool. Let's see where we're at here. Did you hear me tinkling those goddamn ivories? Sorry, getting lost in the sauce there. It happens. All right. Let's keep moving. But yes, that is another really cool one, you know. And it turns out that, I don't know if you are sensing it, but we were getting pretty decent. I mean, we were having a lot of fun. Let's see what we can do moving forward here. And all of this happened organically. That's the thing that amazes me. And didn't think anything of it at the time. Never thought it was in any way exceptional. But now I listened to it. I believe there was something special going on. Let's see where we're at. Okay. We went past the amazing two chords, and now we're to "Catching Satan in a Jar." I'm going to play this for a little bit. Those amazing two chords. Break there, excuse me, got too close to the mic. It just happened naturally, and it starts becoming something else. And Mike comes up with some really cool lyrics for "Catching Satan in a Jar." Some good ones on this tape, but I think for the song I put out from this one, I think we're gonna go with "Catching Satan in a Jar." A little change in the guitar tone. But this really and truly is a two-chord song. I'm not hearing Mike yet. I'm going to move forward a little bit and try to find Mike doing his lyrics on this, because it's really cool.
Growing older.
Oh, we missed part of it.
That's okay.
And eventually he died.
The story behind that, and I believe he was reading, Mike was reading Richard Dawkins, maybe, but the story on that was this guy who basically came out and said, you know, even if he did create it all, God isn't necessary anymore. And enrages the religious, and but then becomes so popular he makes a living out of talking bad about God. And then when he dies, they go to sit by his grave with mason jars to try to catch his soul, his evil soul, as it leaves his body. It's a pretty cool song. Let's see where we can get. What's up next here? We go into Don't Smoke, which, yeah, it's kind of cool. This is still Satan in a Jar, kind of the instrumental part. This episode is going to be too long if I don't get moving, because we're already at 20 minutes and we're not even halfway through. So we got to get to Don't Smoke and Mumbly Scum. Oops. This is Don't Smoke. That's pretty cool. I like it. Fast forward a bit. That thing, somebody was going out for a smoke break and Mike started playing a little bit. Don't, I need a cigarette. And I responded with, don't smoke. And it turned into this thing. So let's see what else is out here. This is Mumbly Scum, I think. Which is a chaotic mess, if I remember. I do need to disclose to you that this is one of the 10 tapes that we had, and I have listened to over and over and over again, so I know it by heart. We could make some fucking noise, man. All right. We're going to move to side two and see what we got going on. Got to rewind a bit. Side two from April 9th, 1998 by The Snout. Mother, I Want My Way, reminiscing about the good old days. Mike calls for spirit guidance. They show up and we don't know what to do. And Way Down South. Let's get this rewound. So there's been a marked improvement in what we're doing. And it's funny because at the time, I don't know if we even thought about or realized that we were actually any good at all. And even after another year of playing, we weren't certain. And that's disappointing to me because I think if we'd kept doing this, we could have turned it into something really, really, really cool. All right, we'll start side two and see what we've got going on here. It's supposed to be Mother, I Want My Way. Oh, and this one is very slow. And Mike kind of sings. He normally doesn't really sing. This one he tries to sing, and he even talks about it in his lyrics that he's trying to sing for real for the first time. And not a great song, but we find a mellow groove. You know, it's not bad. To the meat of this one, but you can hear us there just kind of turning it into what it's going to become, finding our parts. It was always a process, but it was not one that we ever thought about or discussed, but it really was always a process of us each finding a part that worked and then playing around with that part a little bit. So we're at slow. And that one, yeah, it's kind of dull, but it's in a completely different vein, and that's kind of the cool thing too, is we never knew what was going to come out, what style. It was just Snout music. Let's see what we got here.
In the shadow of a new day, Mother
Mike will readily tell you that he can't sing, but I think if we worked on it, he and I could actually have sung together, even in a weird way, in a kind of talking way. Nope, we're still in that, huh? Let's keep her going. Ah, good old cassette tapes. Rewind, fast forward, rewind, fast forward. Oh, went past it. Let's see. You have no idea. It's just guesswork. Still going. I'm trying to get to reminiscing about the good old days. And I think I ended up calling it Rewind Me Back to the Days. Rewind Me Back to the Good Old Days, or Remind Me Back to the Days Remembered, or something like that. His lyrics were specific, so I actually changed the title to his exact wording. Let's see where we're at. Whoa. That does not want to go. We'll get there. Tell you what, I haven't had a single issue with the new tape deck compared to the old crappy ones, the old boom boxes.
Talking to heaven.
All right, we're still on that. It's a long one, I guess. like most all of them are. It's funny, I think nothing of listening to a 20-minute song now. Because that's what we did. Or even 10 minutes. We're still in that. Holy crap, that's a long one. It's got to be half that side. Holy crap, it's still going. Let's try. Holy shit, that's a long one. My goodness. I don't know, maybe I hit rewind instead of fast forward accidentally when I wasn't looking. Because it seems like we should be further along. Okay. This is Rewind Me Back to the Days Revisited. That's what the title I used. And Mike does a weird thing where he goes, and he's actually rewinding the tape of his life as a time traveler. Now this one tells a really cool story as well. Rewind Me Back to the Days Revisited, and it talks about, it's a series of little vignettes, as it were. Talks about sitting in the park with a girl from school and smoking her first joint with him and getting her home before the parents know. And the next one, he's with a girl in the park and they do some acid and he doesn't get her home in time and he gets suspended from school. And the next thing, he's with a bunch of buddies in the park with a transvestite and things are taking a turn. Because in the very end, he's wishing he was in the whatever you call it, gazebo or whatever. Wishing he was in that park on a bench with that transvestite to keep him warm. Because he's homeless at this point or something. It's weird. So it's a really cool thing if you listen to the whole thing, which we're not going to do today. But I don't believe this is the one I'm going to put out. I think I'll put out Catching Satan in a Jar. We'll see.
Remind me back to the days revisited. Good old days. Getting drunk half naked in a park. After midnight, with some girl you think is cute from class. Sharing a joint with her. It's her first joint, she knows you're trouble.
Doesn't that want? Make you want to listen to the rest of the story. It's a really cool tune. All right, we're going to move forward. It's just, yeah. It's weird and cool and excuse me, and organic. It all happened of its own. We just were along for the ride. We were just part of the beast.
I don't even have a home anymore. Thinking about that park. Nice pavilion.
The pavilion, not gazebo. And a transvestite dress, yeah, a pavilion to keep me dry and a transvestite to keep me warm, which I think is. Yeah, and this is Mike calls for spirits guidance. This reminiscing about the good old days turns into this weird chant he does. All right, let's move forward. Yeah, we're still in that. We're trying to get to way down south, which would be the last one on this side. And it just happens weirdly. Let's see. It's very spare. As people, I think, were out for a smoke break, and only a couple of us were playing. We're not quite there yet. But it has the recorder in it. It's just really weird how it develops. And as people come back into the room and pick up their instruments, they all join in, and yeah. Let's see. I know there's no bass here. Just listen to this for a bit. I'll just let this play out and we'll call it the end of this episode. My name is John Dundas, that is, and this is episode 28 of The Snout. We were a band. I hope you enjoyed it. Let's listen to this as we play it out.